The Philippine government is also imposing quarantine restrictions in parts of the Visayas and Mindanao to help slow the spread of COVID-19. Among those areas, Cebu City. Now, what does the new protocol mean for residents there, and what challenges does it pose for the local government? Let's ask Cebu City Mayor Edgardo Labella. Mr. Mayor, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron. Good afternoon to your televiewers.
Magandang hapon po. Now, let's talk about first the spike in cases of the confirmed cases in Cebu City, which prompted you to extend the quarantine, the lockdown there. It's the jail inmates who have contracted COVID-19. What is the total confirmed number now, sir?
Yes, Ron. We have a total number of 352 cases positive of the coronavirus. And of these 352, a great majority of these are asymptomatic. Mm-hmm. There are so many who are asymptomatic. And of the 352, there are 127 who are inmates. I mean, not necessarily inmates. Mm-hmm. 114 are inmates, detainees of the Cebu City Jail, and incidentally, 13 Bureau of Jail Management personnel. So I'm not saying 352. Of the 352, there are about 16 recoveries now. And sad to say, there are 6 deaths until as of today.
Okay, let's talk about the inmates and those jail personnel who have been infected. First, the inmates, where are they located now? Where were they put?
Actually, Ron, when I assumed office last July, I noticed that our jails here is congested. So immediately, I initiated a project we call Operation Decongestion. But you know, it was overtaken by events. Mm-hmm. But one thing good, despite this problem that we have, is that we have another building which has just been finished, another jail facility which can accommodate 3,000 prisoners. Mm. Now, these 114 inmates, because they have been found to be positive, but most are asymptomatic, they have been isolated into this building. And they are being taken care of by jail doctors in coordination with our city health personnel and Department of Health personnel in the region. We never stop. You know, Ron, that's the reason perhaps why there are so many positive cases now, although there are also many negative in the process of conducting massive swab testing and contact tracing, because we have about 40,000 testing kits in the city. Mm. We have purchased about 40,000 plus, I think, an additional of about 20,000 or 10,000 from the Office of the Presidential Assistant for the Visayas. So if there's any report of a single positive case, just like what happened in the jail about 6 days ago or 7 days ago, there was an inmate who died. He was brought to the hospital the night before, and the following day he expired because he was complaining of hard breathing. So immediately after that, we instructed the city health officer to conduct a massive swab testing and contact tracing. And that could perhaps be the reason why we have so many cases now, because of our continuous swab testing and contact tracing.
Now, it's good that you were able to separate those 114 detainees, but the jail population of the Cebu City Jail is around 6,000, if I'm not mistaken. What measures are in place at the Cebu City Jail to avoid the spreading?
Actually, as I've said, when I started assume office, I immediately initiated what we call as Operation Decongestion. But now it has been overtaken by events like this crisis that we are now facing. There are 3,000, or the building can accommodate 3,000. Mm-hmm. Of course, I had a meeting together with my crisis committee, with the warden and the jail officials, that there should be I don't use the word social distancing, the more appropriate term is it should be physical distancing. Mm-hmm. Of the inmates, and maybe considering that there's another building that can accommodate 3,000, maybe we will try to find a way that we can isolate some of them, even if they are not found to be positive. But you're not wrong, there's a problem. If we just transfer this jail personnel from a place quite far from the jail facility, because you need really a court order to that effect. For which reason, Ron, I tried to communicate, and in fact, we may have a meeting with the executive judge, Judge Makaundas Haji Razol, together with my crisis committee, to find a possible way that we could isolate, or we could, we would be able to have this physical distancing from our inmates, considering the number, which is mind-boggling, to say the least.
Right. Now, there have been calls for the Bureau of Corrections to release, for the early release of inmates, most especially those sickly and of the elderly. Are you studying plans for that as well for the Cebu City Jail?
Yes, June. That is one thing that we should seriously consider. And in fact, one of the recommendations when I started to undertake this operation decongestion, because there are really cases, only that they were not properly handled wrong by their, sad to say, by some of the lawyers. There are cases that if only some of these detainees, because some of them are not really convicts by final judgment, they are just detention prisoners. And some of them, if properly guided, like there are some cases that if you invoke like what we call as plea bargaining, mitigating some of the penalties, they could be subject to probation. And this is one thing that, of course, in addition also to what you just said, that the elderly prisoners and who have served more than enough, and maybe if what we call as the good conduct allowance, because you know good conduct allowance sometimes take a long time. But there are, I think, many prisoners, or detention prisoners, that have, you know, been observing good conduct. So maybe on that regard, and of course the elderly and those suffering from diseases.
Now, as we already mentioned, the spike in cases in Cebu City has prompted you to extend the ECQ there up to May 15. And you've already told us the number of confirmed cases at 352. How are your hospitals holding up?
Well, of course, you know, we have also private hospitals here, which are quite sophisticated, so to speak. And of course, they cater to many or some of these COVID-19 patients. And I'm glad that they are very receptive and they have been very cooperative. The owners of the hospital here, we even have frequent meetings every now and then to really, you know, help accommodate some of these COVID patients.
And I understand you're supposed to open up a new quarantine facility by tomorrow. Is that correct?
That is correct. You know that quarantine facility, we really comply with the protocol as required by the Department of Health. And one of the things that, one of the equipment that which is being installed there is what the one that we call as negative pressure equipment, that would see to it that the virus would not spread. This is one of the things, and all the protocols that have been spelled out by the Department of Health are strictly followed and implemented in that quarantine, which can accommodate, by the way, not less than 200 patients. And the priority there will be are those which are considered as having mild and moderate symptoms. And just like the one that is also being dealt in collaboration with the Ateneo de Cebu, Sacred Heart School, private sector, city government, Department of Health. There's another one that can accommodate about 80. It's at the Ateneo de Cebu campus, which is also compliant with the protocols of the Department of Health. And there's another facility, the International Eucharistic Congress, which was used during the Eucharistic Congress here in the city. owned by the Barino family, spouses, that can also accommodate about 500. But until now, it's still under construction. The immediate facilities that we can use for mild and moderate patients are the one, is the one, the Sacred Heart facility. We call it the Bayanihan Center. And also tomorrow, we will be opening the North Reclamation Area Quarantine Center, as again, that can accommodate mild and moderate. For those who are found to have serious and severe, of course, they will be brought directly to the hospitals.
Okay. Now, going back to the lockdown extension, how did the people react to it? How did they receive it?
Well, Ron, you know, I made a declaration for the extension 3 days ago, and I am glad that the president also made the declaration today, and it jived with our extension period, which is May 15. When I made the declaration three days ago, I was even saying that, of course, we would extend it until, because ours is supposed to end our enhanced community quarantine on the 28th of April. But since I sensed the importance of declaring already, considering the increase and the rise of number of cases in the city, I already made a declaration 2 days ago that we will extend it until the 15th of May. And now when I watched the president and heard the president say that it's also going to be for Cebu City and the rest of the local governments, including Cebu province.
Right, sir.
Well, I think I'm right, because the president also shared the same sentiment.
But did the people welcome this extension?
Yes. It's a big yes, because especially here in the city, that there is a rising number of cases. And of course, our neighboring local governments, the adjacent cities, have just also started their mass testing. And according to my good friend, my immediate neighbor, Mayor Jonas Cortez of Mandaue City, he said that he also expects there could be a rise in the number of cases,
right,
because they're starting the mass testing today.
Can the economy of Cebu City still take it, the extension until May 15? And how has been the distribution of relief and financial aid to your residents?
As you know, Ron, insofar as the distribution of relief goods, let us admit the fact that there is never enough. Especially that in our case, the guidelines that we start with the poorest of the poor. In my case, in our case here in Cebu City, about 2 or 3 weeks ago, when we declared that there's going to be an enhanced community quarantine, we distributed 120,000 sacks of rice. Priority should be given to the poorest of the poor, and of course, those dislocated workers, those no work, no pay individuals. Of course, it's not perfect. We really could not, as I said, there's never enough. And a week after that, considering that in our 2020 budget, we have an item on 8 barangays, and Cebu City has about 80 barangays, we again distributed financial assistance. Now, for the first 10 thickly populated barangays, the city gave them 3 million pesos. The next 11 to 40 populated barangays, the city gave them 2 million pesos. For the 41st to 80 barangays populated, the city gave them 1 million pesos. Mm-hmm. And the simple guideline is that 80% of the 3 million, 2 million, and 1 million, respectively, should be devoted to food, and the 20% should be devoted to the for the use or for the purchase of protective equipment like masks, gloves, and disinfectants and alcohol. So I think until now, we have enough. And considering when I declared that we are going to have another or extension of the enhanced community quarantine, I have also declared that there will be a second round of distribution of sacks of rice, 150,000 this time, mm-hmm. 150,000. So that the poorest of the poor, and of course the less fortunate members of the society, would be able to at least survive in the next 2 weeks or so.
Mayor Labella, thank you very much for the updates. We appreciate you taking our call. Please stay safe.
Thank you. Same here, John. You too, and God bless.
Thanks.